deepest secrets of different bills. Add on the Demi, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Move from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm's coming up next. Only scratch the surface. Still, they try to drag my name in dirt, they try to bring me down. See me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, my nephews and nieces? This is your favorite uncle, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. Right now, listen, before we get too far in the video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like, and let's get this video to at least 1,000 likes. That'll definitely push the video to the recommended. And furthermore, if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe. I'm by far the hardest working YouTuber in 2K community, and hopefully you can appreciate that 9 a.m. and that 5 p.m. daily double uploads, and you can show that appreciation by dropping a like and subscribing, right? Now let's get into this video. So today, my nephews and nieces, as you can see, man, we got back-to-back days of next-gen video, man. So hopefully my next-gen nephews and nieces are a little excited for this. I explain all the time why I haven't been doing next-gen videos much. I mean, if we're not getting views on them, there's no need to drop them from a business standpoint. But I do know that there's a handful of my nephews and nieces that do have, obviously, next-gen. So I want to show y'all some love still. So I'm going to give y'all the best point guard build. Obviously, we all know what the wave is right now on next-gen when it comes to point guards. It's a little disappointing, but it is what it is. And if you want to be able to find something that's the best version, man, hopefully you always want to come to Uncle Demi for that. So anyway, we're going point guard. The height of this is going to be, believe it or not, is going to be 5'9". You want to go 169 pounds. And the reason being is because, as you see, that 169 with the wingspan of 5'10". Okay? You want to go 5'10 because that gives you 99. So you see, by going 169... Well, actually, you can go 168, but I went 169. But it doesn't affect anything, but I just want to make sure I have the highest perimeter defense I can possibly have, right? So then body type, in this instance, I'm going to go define. And then this is when things get crazy. So you really just skip all the finishing. You don't really focus on the finishing, right? You want to max out your three-point shot to 99, and then you want to go 95 on your mid-range. And the reason why you want to go 95 because you drop one down, your difficult shots go. So I just basically want to make sure I had everything Hall of Fame, right? Then I just go 27 here in the free throw. So that's all you have. So you have 39. You could potentially get 40 if you wanted to, but this is the route that I went to. On the pass accuracy, I went 85. And the only reason I went 85 is because I wanted to make sure I had bullet passer on gold. And then, of course, we're maxing out that ball handle to 99. And the only reason why we're doing that is because we want to be able to have unpluckable. On Hall of Fame Unpluckable, you basically have to have a 99, and that's what happened. But as we all know, this has been nerfed. I mean, on ball steals has been nerfed. So I don't know if Hall of Fame Unpluckable you even need anymore, but that is still something up for debate. But regardless, there's still so many positives behind being 5'9 is because of the speed, right? That 94 speed, and then of course we're here, the 95 perimeter defense with the 99 steal, okay? That is toxic. And then, of course, we're going to max out the speed and the acceleration. And then we're going to have that remaining left for your stamina. Hold up. I'm sorry. Hold up. Let me see. Do I have everything right here? I think so. But I still have some left over. I don't know how I have something left over. But we're going to go ahead and just drop it right here. All right, bet. So there we go. So until it's 27, we got 29. All right. So basically what we're looking at, I want to make sure I got this right. 95, 99, 85, 99, 94. 95, 99, 99. Yep. Okay. Yeah. So basically this is what you're looking at. 39, 34, 26. This build, literally, we all know the left and righting. Now with circus threes being boosted, you got left righting, fading, hop step threes, you know, like spin jumper threes. Like, it's about as toxic as it gets on this game. And then of course the big one here is that the 99 steal. So you basically, even though you have a lockdown on your team, this build right here can literally not only just get crazy bump steals, but literally on ball steals. Even though they have been nerfed, this build is able to play on ball and be able to work in the pick and roll because it's hard to ISO a build like this. Why? Because this build is just as fast as you. So you basically got 2 5'9s that are just like back and forth. And what makes it even better is that mismatch expert and those type of badges aren't going to be effective on this build because both of y'all are short. So there is a lot of benefits behind that. I know there's some people that are literally having like a 74 defense or like, you know, in the 70s on the perimeter defense and that type of deal. I don't agree with that. I feel like you want to have as much of your perimeter defense instilled as you can, because this build can be extremely viable on the defensive side. Offensively, it's a juggernaut. This is like prime Steph Curry. You can shoot it all over the court. You can dribble really, really fast. You run all over the place. It's just a very toxic build, right? Now, for the takeovers, it's a little different this time now. So now what you want to do is get ankle-breaking shots, because you're doing a lot of step-backs, spin jumpers and stuff with this, going into the corner, fading. So you want to get that. And then you want to get the precision pull-up. Provides a significant boost to well-timed jump shots taken off dribble, because now everything is just hop-step circus threes. So, of course, if you have this, it's just going to enhance it. You do get your sharp takes, you do get playmaking take, and you do get lockdown, okay? So you do get all the takeovers. But I just feel like from an offensive standpoint, you just want to go this route. And that's the reason why we're going with. So then here you have it, my nephews and nieces. You have a playmaking shot creator, 5'9", right? So what we're going to do is this. We're going to test the build out real quick. We'll give them the 99 and then go over some badges. And of course, we'll get you out of here. Okay, so let's just talk about how crazy this is, man. So, so basically here with the two badges, you have nothing. So we're just going fast twitch and grace under pressure, okay? And then here on the shooting side, this is when things get really, really crazy. So one, you want to go lucky seven on bronze, okay? You want to go stop and pop on Hall of Fame. You want to get your mismatch expert. You want to get your hot zone hunter, all right? Now you want to get chef. I was saying circus trees the whole time. You want to get chef. All right, so chef is what you want to go with. And then, of course, you also want to go with circus threes. High difficulty shots on spin jumpers and all that type of deal, all right? And then, of course, you want to get sniper. Oops. All right. Now, some people use stop and pop. Others use rhythm shooter. But in the grand scheme of things, the next step that you want to go with, believe it or not, is you want to go ahead and go with gold corner specialist. Because if you're going to be fading in the corner, this is what you want to have. You want to have that ability to be able to do that, okay? Trust me, gold corner specialist. With that last five, of course, it's going to be blinders. We all know that. So this is what I would rock with. I mean, obviously, there's no right or wrong answer. Keep in mind, you also would get a +4. You can put it on your playmaking or your shooting. So there's another +4 you can mess with. And then every single season you hit level 40, you get another +1. So you can literally keep working your way up till you can get Deadeye or Green Machine or something like that. But for the most part, these are the badges that are really going to stand you, set you apart. On the playmaking side, obviously you want to get, where are we at? Quick Chain Hall of Fame. You want to get your Bullet Passer on gold. I will always say get Glue Hands at least on gold. Get Dimer on bronze. You want to get your Bell Out on bronze. Your Quick First Step Hall of Fame. Your Unpluckable Hall of Fame. All right. Your Tight Handles Hall of Fame. And then your Handles for Days, which I guess is, I got to drop something down. Because your Handles for Days, you want to have Hall of Fame too. So let's just drop the Glue Hands down then. Let's drop it down. And then here, and then we have one. Okay, now we can get Glue Hands on silver. Okay. So this is what I would go with. Some people don't even use Dimer. For obvious reasons, it's just so easy to shoot. You could use that on hyperdrive on bronze, which I think that would be the best bet, to be honest with you. But tight handles, ISOing with tight handles, fading the corner with the badges you have is toxic. This one right here, obviously, you want to go pickpocket, clamps, pick dodger, interceptor. I guess we'll go, let's go menace, all right? And then we can get Hustler on bronze. So this is what I would rock with, all right? Well, there you have it, my nephews and nieces. This is the best point guard on NBA 2K22 Next Gen. Let me know in the comment section if you agree or disagree, or what build you think is the best. But other than that, this is your favorite old head, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon on the Banger Man. And you know, when I say I'm back soon on the Banger, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.
If he call for a low, we gon' give it to him. Take that stop off the top of no transformer. Man, we're ducking and dodging on that corner. Doing flip with a beat like a mighty morpher. Told myself to get rich and go have a